talk about table tennis from the one, you know, on court, the one on the table.
Mm-hmm.
The 2019 Nigeria Table Tennis National Junior Championship will be serving off today at the National Stadium. Already we have like 63 boys and 32 girls drawn across the country. They've already started for the 9-day tournament, and it's going to serve as ranking point for the under 18 players in the country. So this is another opportunity for the Nigerian Table Tennis Federation. The last time it was for the ladies, mm-hmm. I mean singles, for mm-hmm. the ladies and all. This time around they're looking at the junior. So it's like they're really, you know, developing top players and all that. We know the likes of Usman Okolanwo and Sadiat Akim, who are the current African junior champions of West Africa because of the tournament they went for the last time and all that. They emerged champions and everything in Ghana. So it simply means this junior championship is also going to give room for more younger players, you know, to come forward.
Yeah. Aside the 1 million naira prize money, there's also the fact that the organizers are saying players will be compensated, outstanding players will be compensated for their performance in this tournament, and that's very good. I'm always happy to see things like this, you know, just tournament after tournament. Just look, there's a large pool to mm-hmm. discover talents, give these guys the opportunity to show what they can do, and that's just what the NGTF doing. And this junior league, I hope it throws up more interesting names, mm-hmm. Players that can be nurtured, you know, to stardom, so that, you know, I'm not really bothered about who wins.
Yeah.
I'm bothered about the outstanding players and the compensation. I don't know what the compensation means, but I'm beginning to think that the compensation might mean some form of encouragement. Yeah, some incentives
and all that.
Encouragement here and there to keep these guys in line. The problem with most sports in Nigeria, apart from football, is that most of these guys do it part-time.
Yeah.
Part-time, you know, but encourage these guys to say, look, you can devote your time, your energy, your resources into this sport and you get to the top.
And also make money out of
yeah.
it. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Get to the top, make money, achieve whatever you want to achieve in life doing this. But once it's part-time, you're distracted, one competition in a year, it's not going to help. But all of this, you know, I just hope that is a conversation that I'm really worried, that I'm really concerned about. Not the prize money.
Okay.
Because whatever price money you get, you're going to finish spending it, even if it is 10 million.
Mm-hmm.
But the compensation, all of those incentives,
that comes with
inducement, whatever, scholarship, anything that will help those guys stay in the game.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what it is. And of course, on the final day, they will be having the one for under 21 players for the likes of Taiwo Manti, mm-hmm. Aziz Sholanke, Jamil Ayawalo. You also have Abayomi and Imashan, all of them. Augustine, Emmanuel, and Tosi Olubamishi, they will all be competing in the under 21 category. That's on the final day. So those ones will also have opportunity to have just a one day mm-hmm. tournament and all that in the competition. That's a good one coming from Nigeria Table Tennis Federation. Still talking local sports right now. Let's talk about Georgia Obo. Man, she has actually improved in her ranking, the Rolex Golf ranking right now, becoming the first Nigeria to make the world ranking. So she's once again set a new record. I mean, ranked in the list
1,128. That's the position.
The yeah.
But to be noticed.
Yeah.
By the world, buddy, for your name, yeah. in whichever position, for your name to be there, it shows that you're doing something right. We've always talked about yeah. this young upcoming star who's, you know, putting Nigeria on the
yeah.
map for all the good reasons, and I'm happy with this one. And I mean, the future is bright.
Yeah,
you know,
very,
the future
very.
Is bright. Just, I mean, all those competitions that she's participated in, all those steps that she's been taking,
yeah.
we're beginning to see the dividends. It might take a while before she breaks into, you know, maybe the hundreds, maybe yeah. top below 100. It's going to take a lot of effort, mm. but it's doable.
Yeah, absolutely, it's doable. And remember, she won her professional tournament in Cote d'Ivoire the last time. That was in 2018. And December last year in Morocco, you know, when she competed in the Ladies European Tour and card in category 9B. So that was at the qualifying mm-hmm. school in Morocco. That also, you know, gave her the opportunity becoming the first Nigerian golfer to have a ranking in golf. So remarkable one for her. Talking about Nigerian players, late Saturday, we're going to be seeing Divine Odudiri's Tony Professional, I mean, Monaco Grand Prix. I can't wait to actually see her. Blessed Nokagbere also will be in action later today also at the Monaco Grand Prix. That's the Diamond League from the IWF.
All right. So okay. That's it for golf. Let's quickly travel abroad. Let's basketball. Talk Formula One. Formula One.
Before that, basketball.
Okay, basketball. Here. Yeah, okay. Let's talk about the guys. They've been doing us proud.
Yeah.
And today they're playing Tunisia?
Mm-hmm, absolutely, they'll be playing Tunisia. But then the thing is, they've been able to beat Algeria 74-64 in their final group game. We talked about the fact that they qualified
for
the
final
with a game to spare. And that game, they won it 75-64. That's their final group game. So they finished second on 7 points behind group leaders, Egypt, who ended the group with 8 points. Remember their first game, they lost
to Egypt,
went on to beat the host nation and all that. The first set and second quarters, at the first quarter and second quarter, it was 24-12, 15-11. Then the Algerians were able to win the third and the fourth quarters. But then because of the lead that they gave them in that second quarter, especially at 15-11 and 24-12, which was pretty cool, that was how they were able to get something out of it. James Okemiri contributing 19.8 rebounds in the win against the North Africans. As you mentioned, they'll be facing Tunisia today. Of course, this is seeking a place to get into
That's the ultimate. That's the ultimate, really.
2020,
yeah.
On the 7th.
So the boys doing well in Cape Verde. Hopefully, the objective, the aim for this tournament, which is to pick a ticket for the FIBA Under-17 Basketball Championship, will be achieved. All right.